In this problem, we're given three relations in the form of tables, as we see here below, and we're asked to determine which tables are one-to-one functions. To test to see if a relation is a one-to-one function, we first have to test to see if it's a function, and then test to see if it's a one-to-one function. So let's review both definitions. A function is a relation in which every input has exactly one output. Remember, the inputs are the x values, or the domain, and the outputs are the y values of the range. An easier way to think of this is, a relation is a function if every x has exactly one corresponding y value. So once we know a relation is a function, we can then test to see if it's a one-to-one function. A one-to-one function is a function in which each input has one unique output. Again, an easier way to think of this is, a function is one-to-one if every y has exactly one corresponding x. So looking at our tables, we first want to determine if they're functions and then if they're one-to-one functions. If they're not functions, they can't be one-to-one functions. After you do this a while, you can probably answer these questions leaving it in the table format, but when first learning how to do this, I think mapping the table makes it a lot easier. So let's look at this first table on the next slide. To map this relation, we're going to place the set of x values or inputs here, and the set of y values or outputs here, and then map the relation. So looking at the x values, we have three unique x values. We have -4, -2, and +1. Even though 1 occurs twice, we only list it once. These are the unique x values. And then for the y values, we have 3, 5, and 9. Again, notice how 3 occurs twice. And now to map the relation, when x is -4, y is +3, so we'll draw a segment from -4 to +3. When x is -2, y is +5, so we draw a segment from -2 to +5. When x is 1, y is 9, so we draw a segment here. And then when x is 1, y is also +3, so we draw another segment from 1 to 3. Now the function test is to make sure every x has exactly one corresponding y value. In this form, we can easily see that the x value of +1 corresponds to two different y values. It corresponds to +3 and +9. Therefore, this relation is not a function. And if it's not a function, it can't be a one-to-one function either. So we'll go ahead and say it's not a function and move to the next relation. Next, we'll go ahead and map our second relation. Looking at the x values, notice how there's no repetition. So we have -4, -2, 1, 3. There is repetition in the y values, though. The set of y values will be -5, +2, and 0. Now we'll map our relation. -4 maps to -5. -2 maps to +2. +1 maps to 0, and +3 maps to 2. We'll first test to see if it's a function, meaning every x has exactly one corresponding y. And that is true. Notice every x value only has one segment moving toward the right. So this is a function. Now we'll see if it's a one-to-one function, meaning every y has exactly one corresponding x. So looking at the y values now, notice how the y value of +2 actually has two corresponding x values. Therefore, while this is a function, it's not one-to-one. This y value corresponds to the x value of -2 and the x value of +3. So it's a function, but not one-to-one. Now let's test our third relation. Notice there's no repetition in x values or y values. So the mapping is very straightforward. -2 maps to 3, -1 maps to 4, 0 maps to 5, and 1 maps to 8. So we'll first see if it's a function, meaning every x has exactly one corresponding y, which it does. Notice every x value only has one segment moving toward the right, so it's a function. And to test to see if it's a one-to-one function, we want to see if every y has exactly one corresponding x. Looking at the y values, notice each y value is only paired with one x because there's only one segment leaving each y value moving toward the left. So this is a function, and it's also a one-to-one function. So you may have picked up on the shortcut here. If there's no repetition in the y values or the x values, then as a table, the relation would be a one-to-one function. But hopefully by mapping these, you have a better understanding of what it means to be a one-to-one function. I hope you found this helpful.